So this video is to complete our talk about the hematological or hemostasis disorders. Okay, in the previous video I talked about the hemophilia, okay, and the hemophilia was the first part of the coagulopathy. Okay, we divide the hematological disorders into platelets and coagulopathy. The hemophilia was the first part of the coagulopathy, and now we're going to talk about the von Hippel disease. In the next video I'm going to talk about the thrombosis diseases. Okay, let's go to the von Hippel diseases. Okay, actually hemophilia, I told you that is a somewhat recessive X-linked. Okay, the von Hippel disease is autosomal dominant. Okay, and it is not X-linked, it is just an autosomal dominant disease. Rarely it is a recessive, most of the times it is autosomal dominant. The von Hippel are molecules that play a role in adhesion of the platelets to the endothelial layers of the vessels, of the blood vessels. Okay, so this is the blood vessel. I suspect that by now, or expect by that by now, you all know that the von Hippel factors are the factors that adhere the platelets to the endothelial layer of the blood vessels. Okay, so this is the first function of the von Hippel. The second function that protects factor 8 from rapid clearance. So in a way or another, there is some connection between the von Hippel disease and factor 8. So if we have a problem with von Hippel, we will have deficiency in factor 8 in a lot of cases. The types of von Hippel disease actually is either the affection of the quantitative quantitative deficiency, okay, in the quantity of von Hippel, the count of von Hippel disease factors, or equality deficiency. Quality deficiency, the quantitative deficiency of von Hippel may be type 1 or type 3. Type 1, which is the most common type of von Hippel deficiency. We have mild to moderate deficiency in von Hippel factors. Okay, in type 3 we have a severe deficiency in the number of von Hippel factors. You now may ask yourself, where's type 2? Type 2 is the qualitative deficit of the von Hippel. Type 2 is dysproteinemia. Okay, we have a problem in the shape of von Hippel factor. Okay, type 1. Type 3 is in the number of von Hippel factor. Type 1 is the most common, it is mild to moderate deficiency. Type 3 is less common and severe deficiency. How does the von Hippel disease manifest clinically? Mostly it is manifested as epistaxis, mucocutaneous bleeding, gingival bleeding or cutaneous bleeding. Okay, menorrhagia is very, very important as a manifestation of von Hippel disease, and it's quite common. Okay, also a bleeding after pregnancy or after delivery, after some weeks of delivery, is also common in von Hippel disease. Okay, what can we find in the lab results of von Hippel disease? Actually, the von Hippel amount is the first to be counted in the lab results of suspected von Hippel disease. It will be reduced von Hippel factors. Okay, it will be reduced in amount, especially in type 1 and type 3. How does we count the von Hippel? Is via von Hippel factor antigen, okay, technique, and von Hippel activity also is measured by erythrocytic. Okay, so this is how to measure von Hippel amount, antigen, and the activity. A bleeding time and the prothrombin time also may increase. Okay, in severe cases we factor 8 may be profound, may decrease. Okay, and the patient will present cases just like hemophilia A, but it is not a hemophilia A. Hemophilia is a X-link or sex disease. Okay, and presented as hemarthrosis. Okay, but this is in just in severe cases. What is treatment of von Hippel factors? most of you will say that it is we treat von Brandt factor deficiency or disease by giving von Willebrand factor. This is right, but this is not in mild or moderate cases. Okay, in mild and moderate cases we just give desmopressin, like in hemophilia. Mild and moderate cases also we can give desmopressin, as I told you in the previous video. So desmopressin is given in the mild and moderate cases. In severe cases, right, we give von Willebrand factors. Okay, how to calculate the dose is just like when we calculate the dose of factor A deficiency. The desired level of von Willebrand factor is multiplied by the weight of the patient in kgs by 0.5. okay, just like in hemophilia A, we count the dose in von Willebrand factor. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. See you in the next and the final video of the hematological or bleeding disorders. In the next video I'm going to talk about the thrombosis and about DIC, and by this I will end up. Thank you very much. See